Шануємо їх пам'ять хвилиною мовчання.
Саме така незрадна і безкомпромісна позиція Бориса Джонсона
будь-яких обставинах та виконає всі свої обіцянки. Ми продовжуємо підтримувати вашу боротьбу, боротьбу України за свободу так довго, як буде потрібно до перемоги України. Наголосив тоді Борис Джонсон, і цю підтримку ми всі відчуваємо і досі. Ставши лідером світового масштабу за часів свого прем'єрства, пан Джонсон залишається таким і сьогодні, незалежно від посад і реалій. Шановна урочиста академія, в одному зі своїх листів до університетської спільноти вересня минулого року Борис Джонсон пообіцяв продовжувати робити все можливе, щоб і надалі підтримати Україну. І нині ми можемо з впевненістю сказати, що Борис Джонсон дотримується свого слова, як і залишається непохитним, вірним своїй позиції. Україна має перемогти Росію і перемогти її на Україні. 4 жовтня 2022 року вчена Рада Львівського університету присвоїла звання почесний доктор Лорис Кауза Львівського національного університету імені Івана Франка Борису Джонсону, високо оцінивши його головний особистий внесок в захист української належності та відданість ідеалам свободи і демократії. І сьогодні ми з великою приємністю вітаємо нашого почесного доктора Бориса Джонсона в академічній родині Львівського університету. І зі щирою вдячністю наголошую, що Львівський університет та весь український народ завжди пам'ятатиме того, хто у темні часи подарував нам світло надії, у час нерішучості продемонстрував принциповість та відданість демократичних цінностей, у просторі страху та небезпек взяв на себе тягар лідерства на шляху до нашої спільної перемоги. Шановний пане Джонсон, дозвольте мені від імені університетської спільноти вручити вам диплом почесного доктора Львівського національного університету імені Івана Франка.
Thank you very much. I feel, as we say in the UK, why to supporting Ukraine. Yesterday, I went to a rehabilitation centre in Kyiv, and I met some of the soldiers, the heroes who have suffered such cruel injuries from mines or tanks or artillery shells, and I saw the wonderful care that they are getting and how they learn to recover the use of their limbs, faculties, and slowly regain their strength and their way of living. Though, of course, for many of them, life will never be the same again. And I felt humbled by their sacrifice, by their bravery. Though they kept rejecting the idea that they had been brave when I said it. They said they were just doing their job, defending their country. And I must say that I felt absolute fury that these peaceful men, and I must be frank and tell you all that the injured soldiers that I saw were all men. And I know of course that many women have also been killed and injured in this terrible conflict. But I felt rage that these husbands, these fathers, sons, Ukrainians from so many different occupations and walks of life should suffer the same set, the same type of horrifying wounds, time after time, day after day, because of the folly and vanity of one man in the Kremlin, in Moscow, who decided he was going to use violence to destroy the freedom of Ukraine. Because that is fundamentally what this war is all about. When Vladimir Putin invaded this innocent and beautiful country, it was because he could not stand the fact that you have decided to live your lives in freedom and to take a different path from Russia, to be a democracy, to choose your leaders by voting in peace and without coercion, knowing that your will will be respected. And so your fight, the fight of Ukraine, has become the fight for freedom around the world. And it's the fight for not just for free elections, but for free speech, for academic and intellectual freedoms, which go hand in hand with free speech, and which flourish in this ancient university, and which are the basis, academic, intellectual freedom to say what you think. They are the basis of all human progress and innovation and prosperity. And Putin couldn't stand the path of freedom that Ukraine had decided to take. And that's why he did what he did. And that's why your resistance is so heroic, in my view. And when I talked to those injured soldiers, I felt a surge of burning impatience and frustration that we in the West are not doing more now to get those Ukrainian troops, your armed services, the equipment they need that will help them to win the war faster, to shorten this conflict, and to save lives, and to save suffering, and to stop more people on both sides being injured in the way that I saw. And I vow to you, I tell you, that I will go back tonight to the UK and I will campaign again and again to help secure for Ukraine the supplies and assistance that you need.
Дозвольте запитати нашу академічну
Son, why?
Many things in this make it wonder.
How interesting. How interesting. Wow. It has a distinguished history, this museum, at this university. I've had a wonderful day so far, and I thank the Ivan Franko University, the students, the distinguished faculty, the rector for inviting me. Great honour you've done me, conferring an honorary degree upon me. And it seems like a wonderful university, and I hope very much that we will intensify the collaboration between this university and I think it's Birmingham University in the UK. And that. What's that? Yes, yes. Well, I hope so. I mean, and I gather that Ivan Franko was the translator of Shakespeare into Ukrainian. So I will study his translation, because they're fascinating to, even if you can't read Ukrainian, you can piece it out. And anyway, I congratulate you on being head of the student body. You have to be elected.
Yeah, she was elected.
Wow. That's democracy.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Absolutely.
I had to be elected. I was head of something called the Oxford Union, which is a thing in... Congratulations.
Faculty of Chemistry.
And you're the...
Trade union leader, right?
Good. Congratulations. So are you campaigning for better rights for students?
Sure, he does. He's doing that.
Really?
Yeah,
what are you ordering? So, cigarettes? No cigarettes.
No cigarettes is prohibited here. As any other
words. Better food in the canteen? Cheaper prices in the bar. If I give you one piece of advice, campaign for cheaper alcohol in the student bar.
Can you sign it, please?
Can you sign it, please?
Oh, please be loved.
Mr. Johnson! Mr. Johnson! Mr. Johnson!